And I just call you a bitch. They gon' hate on my bitch.
My camera is dying, and I'm not even gonna lie. Today, this week, these past few last 24 hours have been testing my patience.
So, if you've made it to this portion of this video, first off, welcome. And I don't even know where to start. I've had like the craziest week, the craziest last 24 hours. So my account got hacked, my Instagram account got hacked, and my Facebook account got hacked. So I don't have that anymore, fighting to get it back. But for now, follow me on my new account. We're hoping that in 30 days, I can get my old account back, my old Instagram account back. Ugh, praying and hoping. But if I don't, I have to start, and I can't wait for 30 days to find that out. So with that being said, not only am I on a mission to 100 subscribers, shout out to the 60 of you that are subscribed to me, that have joined the family. And obviously by joining the family, I do mean subscribe. We just need 40 more of you. So if you come across this video, please do your girl a favor. I had a very stressful 24 hours. And just subscribe to my channel. Also, if you have an Instagram, go ahead and subscribe to my Instagram, where I will be uploading all, you know, new work, old work, now that it's gone and I've been hacked. And, you know, just join me on this journey of building. But today's video is not about that. So let's get into, and this drink, awesome. But let's get into what this video is really about. Hey you guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Renee, also aka RFORD. If you're new to my channel, I'm an artist, I do beauty content, I am going to start doing more music reviews because I really love music and I should probably get a little bit more into it. And then eventually I'm going to blog, you know, just a channel of randomness, but overall I do art, I'm an artist. You see the art in the background. So in today's video, what I'm going to be talking about and showing, it is going to be a time lapse, but I'm also going to kind of narrate my one of my pieces that I did, because I didn't want to just put up a time lapse video. I figured why not talk a little bit, try a little different format of an editing style. So here we are. And in today's video, it's going to be about the painting that I did for Ocho Cinco. So stay tuned. And if you like the shirt also, you guys, I have this shirt. It comes in white. It comes in white, black woman on the blueprint, period, purr. And it also comes in black, and I'll put up a picture of the black one as well. You can head over to my website where these shirts are available right now in two styles, in the white version and also the black version. And they are going for $20 on my website, so go ahead and check it out if you're interested. I do ship nationally and also and international, and also coming out with some new styles soon, so stay tuned. And also subscribe to my mailing list on my website so you can be updated when I do come out with the new versions of these shirts. All right, so let's get into this video. I'm basically just gonna be talking and narrating a little bit about a painting that I did for Chad Johnson, Ocho Cinco. I did have it on my old page, and when you're seeing this, I might not have uploaded it yet on my Instagram, but probably, because, you know, cross promotion. But early last year, I was commissioned to do a painting for Chad Johnson. Shout out to you if you're watching. Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity. And I basically found it through, I got the opportunity through word of mouth. So one of my old coworkers, and one of, she follows me on Instagram too. Shout out to you, Ebony. She's the one who actually sent me the opportunity. She saw it on Twitter. I guess he had tweeted out that he was looking for someone to do like a pop art painting for him. And lo and behold, there was me. You know, I do pop art style work. And she knows that. She follows me. She's been following me for a while and has supported me. She's also one of my collectors. She has one of my paintings as well. And she sent me the tweet. So, you know, I went over to Twitter and I was like, all right, I'm gonna shoot my shot. Why not? So I responded to his tweet with a few of my paintings, you know, my website, my Instagram, check me out. He didn't respond. So what I had to do, I went to Instagram and I DM'd him, and I waited probably a day or two, and then he ended up responding, and that's when the process began. So in this video, I'm actually gonna show you guys like the sketch that I sketched out originally for him, so you can see what it looked like, and then, you know, you guys will also see me painting this painting as well. So stay tuned. So one of the things that I really enjoyed about doing this painting is that he gave me a lot of creative control. So a lot of times when I get a commission request, I do ask questions just so I can get an idea of what it is that the person wants with their art. My favorite ones are when people just give me creative control. So he told me basically do whatever I want. And if I remember, because this was last year, if I remember correctly, he did say that he wanted orange in it. That was like his biggest thing. He wanted like an orange background. He wanted it to be pop art. He knew it was pop. Perfect. So I'm not really a football fan. I know who he is, but I didn't know really much about him. So what I did, I Googled, just did a little Google research on him. I watched a few interviews that I could find on him on YouTube. And then I kind of just went through his Instagram to see like things that he liked. So when you look at the painting, one of the things, well, there's three major components, or really four, to this painting. The first thing is an Xbox controller. So I know that he's a gamer. He and that's from just going through his Instagram and also his tweets and stuff, just trying to find out more about him. And I saw that he was a gamer, so I didn't know which console that he really used a lot. So, but I did see one with an Xbox, so I just chose the Xbox controller. And I personally like how it came out. I did get flack from, I guess, the gamers, and they're like, oh, why didn't you do a PlayStation? Well, I just did it, okay? And he liked it, so relax. But I chose the Xbox controller, and then I realized that he really enjoyed FIFA. So that's where the soccer balls came in at, and he also, in one of the interviews, talked about how he plays soccer as well. So I wanted to incorporate that as well. And then the cigar, obviously he has a cigar line. I think it's called 85 Cigars, if I'm correct. So I wanted to incorporate all these elements that would speak to who he is and what he likes. And then obviously the football team with the orange in the back. So that's where the background inspiration came from, with the stripes. So we had to tie all that together. I sketched out a sketch for him, took a picture of it, sent him the image, and then like all my other clients, once they approve what they like as far as the sketching goes, then it's time to take it to canvas. So he did tell me he wanted a big piece, so that's why I kind of went, you know, big. And that was honestly probably one of the biggest pieces that I had done. Well, I did a big piece as well that I did for Meek Mill. Not for him. Well, I did it for him. He didn't request it, but that's a whole nother story. But I did end up getting to meet him and giving it to him last year, 2020, in the beginning. It was Super Bowl weekend, actually, pre-pandemic. So that's another story for another day. But if you would like that story, comment down below, Meek Mill story, and I can do a short video on that. So. But back to the topic at hand. So being that I knew that I was going to be doing like a pop art piece, I did want everything to have like detail. I wanted it to stick out. And I really love that I did get to work with the orange. It kind of let me get out of my element a little bit, because I've never really used orange like that. And I feel like it really complemented the piece and made everything else just pop, because the controller was black. Everything else was like neutral colors. So as far as the soccer balls though, so the finished product was soccer balls, but my original concept was actually going to be the FIFA like logo in the soccer balls and like the United States. If I can find an image of the reference that I was going to use, I'll stick it in the video right here, if I can find it. But that was going to be what I was originally going to do in it, and I did end up starting to paint the balls blue. I don't know if I still have footage of that, but I might have photos of it. And then, you know, as I kept going, I wasn't sure if he was gonna like it. So, cause like I said, he gave me a lot of creative control. So I decided to play a little safe, and I just decided to go with the soccer balls instead. So I mean, overall, I think that my favorite feature of the painting is the cigar. The cigar in person, I'm telling you, so much detail, it looks so good. I was impressed by myself, at least. So yeah, so for the rest of the video, I'll probably pop in and out to narrate a little bit, but overall, that is basically how I got the opportunity, where the concept came from, why I chose the things that I chose to put onto the painting, and just give you guys a little background instead of just throwing a time lapse up and some music over it. So, but I'm not really sure how long this video is going to be because I'm actually in the editing process and it is an hour, but I'm not going to leave it at an hour. So I may take scenes out, don't know yet. But either way, enjoy the rest of this video. And if you like these type of videos, please go ahead and like this video. Leave me a comment if you guys are interested to hear the time I met Meek Mill and gave him the painting. And what else? I guess subscribe. You guys know that I am on a mission to 100 subscribers, where it's currently at 60. So we're definitely almost there. And I appreciate every single last one of you who have subscribed to me. Please follow me on my new Instagram. As you guys heard, my Instagram has been hacked. And I had almost 4,000 followers on there. It may not be lots of other people, but that was a lot for me, especially for how long I've been trying to grow my page and my brand. So yeah, follow me on Instagram. Go ahead, like, comment, and subscribe on this video. And also share if you enjoyed this video and if you enjoy content like this. Thank you guys for tuning in. And until next time, bye.
Thank you.